Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Recently DxO launched a new product called PureRAW, which I reviewed positively at the time. PureRAW is a raw file preprocessor that applies some of DxO's flagship technologies to optimize image quality. The processed raw file is then saved in the DNG format, which is a halfway house between a raw file and an image. You can still manipulate the DNG image like a raw file, but the DxO quality improvements are permanently applied to the image. In this video, I'm going to share my PhotoLab workflow, which I use to replace PureRAW. Let's start in PhotoLab 4 by looking at the corrections that are applied in the DxO PureRAW software. Whilst I can't be 100% certain, I believe there are four sets of corrections applied by PureRAW. There is the deep prime noise reduction and demosaicing, which I know is applied. Then there is the lens sharpness and chromatic aberration corrections. And finally, we have the distortion correction. Do remember that, as with PureRAW, some of these corrections require a DxO module to be installed. This means your camera and lens combination need to be supported by the software, or you won't see the benefit. Whilst I think these are the same corrections as applied by DxO PureRAW, PhotoLab also allows you to set the strength of the correction, which PureRAW currently doesn't. For example, if you find the default lens sharpness too strong, you can refine the setting to suit your taste. Of course, it can take time to apply these settings to each image, so it's worth creating a preset in the preset editor, which I've already done. After applying the corrections to the first image, I can click this arrow to access the preset menu. Next, select to save a new preset from the current settings and enter a name so you can recognize it in the future. I already have a preset saved to use with the RAW files from this camera and can easily apply it to any image or images in the folder. With the new settings applied, I can choose to export the image to a DNG file just like in PureRAW. To do this, all I need to do is select the file or files I want to export and then click the Export to Disk button. Now it is possible you will see a different button here because the button changes depending on the previous export performed. You can, though, access the other options by clicking the small icon to the right of the button. When the dialog opens, I'll select the format I want to use by clicking the preset on the left. It's also possible to create a new preset, which you can configure to meet your format needs. Let's create a new preset to export the DNG file with only the optical corrections applied. We'll export the file to the same folder as the original RAW file, but we'll put them in a DxO subfolder, just like PureRAW would. We'll also keep the _DxO suffix, which is appended to the end of the file name for exported files. In case you weren't already aware, it's possible to export the image with multiple formats at the same time. You just need to activate the file type by clicking the option box to the left of the preset. I can then click the export option to process the RAW file and create the DNG file. The problem this creates for me though is that I'm using Lightroom to manage my folders of original RAW files. When I use the export to file option, the new DNG files aren't added to the Lightroom catalog. You have the same issue in PureRAW, but there I can use the export to option, which causes Lightroom to import the new images. Fortunately, we can do the same thing and more in PhotoLab. Let's start with a Lightroom example before looking at a couple of other options. As before, I'll click the export icon, but this time I'll select the export to Lightroom option. This opens a slightly different dialog where I can select the Lightroom version to use. This is useful if you have multiple versions installed. The image format options are a little more limited though than when we save the file to disk. For example, whilst I can select the DNG format, I can't control the suffix appended to the file name. The location also defaults to the same folder as the original RAW file. After I click the export button, the file is processed and then I'm switched into Lightroom. Initially, nothing happens and I can get on with other work, but then periodically Lightroom folders are automatically synchronized to import the new file. The new file then appears in a DxO PhotoLab collection set. This contains other collections that use the date and time of the export from PhotoLab as their name. I find this extremely useful, and if I switch to viewing the image folder, I can see the new DNG file grouped into a stack with the original RAW file. Let's now go back to PhotoLab and look at another export option. This time I want to use the Export To application. As before, I can select the file format I want to use, but I can also select the application to export the processed image to. Let's pick Lightroom Classic again, as I want to show you how it differs from the Export to Lightroom feature we used before. This time when I export the image, it immediately starts an import, which is the same behaviour as you see in DxO PureRAW. This doesn't though add the image to the DxO PhotoLab collection, and it doesn't stack the image with the original RAW file. Personally, I prefer the first method of exporting to Lightroom, but you may prefer this one. Now, if the application I want to use doesn't appear in the list, I can use the Browse option to pick it. I should also mention that the drop-down list you're looking at is really a history list of applications used in the past, and you can clear it. This time, let's select the Affinity Photo application and use the TIFF file format. Now I can export my image as a TIFF file and have it automatically open in Affinity Photo. This works just the same as with PureRAW, except that in PhotoLab I have a couple more file format options. This is how I can make DxO PhotoLab do the same job as PureRAW and produce the same quality with no more effort. And whilst PhotoLab Elite costs more than PureRAW, it has a lot more features.